Welcome everyone. In the next lecture on eigenvalues and eigenvectors. In the previous lecture, we have discussed one problem where we calculated the eigenvector using the concept of a solution of homogeneous system. Now in today's lecture, we are going to see one more problem of same type, but while calculating the eigenvalues, while calculating the eigenvectors, we are going to use the Cramer's rule. Now, when you will apply the Cramer's rule, the condition is if all eigenvalues are distinct, then only the Cramer's rule will work. So let's begin with the problem. In today's lecture, I am going to discuss a problem which is frequently asked in the university examination. So let's start with the example. Okay, now come to the problem. Determine the eigenvalues and eigenvector of matrix capital A, where the matrix A is 8, minus 6, 2, minus 6, 7, minus 4, 2, minus 4, 3. So we have to calculate the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of this given matrix. Okay, so let's begin with this. Now, as I discussed in the previous example, the shortcut way of getting the characteristic equation. So that part we would like to apply. Okay, so now first we start with the characteristic equation. The characteristic equation is determinant of A minus lambda I is equal to 0. So here the determinant of A minus lambda I can be written as 8 minus lambda, 7 minus lambda, 3 minus lambda. These are our diagonal elements. Now non-diagonal elements of A will remain same. There is no change. Minus 6, then 2 and then minus 4 is equal to 0. Now solve this determinant. So value of the determinant is 8 minus lambda into bracket. Just a minute. Seven minus lambda into 3 minus lambda. Minus. Minus 4 into minus 4 becomes plus 60. Minus. Minus 6 into bracket. Minus 6 into 3 minus lambda. Minus 2 into minus 4. 2 into minus 4, that is minus 8. Next. Plus 2 into bracket. Minus 6 into minus 4, that is 24, minus 2 into 7 minus lambda is equal to 0. After simplification of this, what we get? We get lambda cube, okay? The next term is minus, addition of the diagonal elements, that is 8 plus 7 plus 3, into lambda square, plus the next term coefficient is calculated as first the sum of product of two diagonal elements taken at a time. So first two elements are 8 and 7, then 7, 3, and then 3 and 8. So 8 into 7 plus 7 into 3 plus 3 into 8. Now subtraction of what? Non-diagonal elements product. So minus 6 into minus 6. Next, again minus, 2 into 2, minus, minus 4 into minus 4, into lambda raised to 1, next term is minus, determinant of A is equal to 0. Now we have to calculate the determinant of A for this matrix. Can you tell me what is the determinant of A here? It's very simple. This is my matrix A, whose determinant is first 8 into bracket, 7 into 3, माइनस माइनस फोर इंटू माइनस फोर, सो सेवन थ्री जा 21, माइनस माइनस फोर इंटू माइनस फोर बिकम्स प्लस 16. नेक्स्ट टर्म इज माइनस, दिस इज माइनस एंड दिस माइनस सिक्स बिकम प्लस 6 इंटू ब्रैकेट माइनस 6 इंटू 3, दैट इज माइनस 18, माइनस 4 टू जा 8, दैट इज माइनस 8 बिकॉज 4 इज अ माइनस, 4 हैविंग द माइनस साइन, प्लस 2 इंटू ब्रैकेट माइनस 6 इंटू माइनस 4, दैट गिवस 24, माइनस 7 टू जा इज इक्वल टू, ओके. सो नाउ यू जस्ट गो ऑन कैलकुलेट दिस वैल्यू विच इज अ वेरी सिंपल कैलकुलेशन वी हैव टू परफॉर्म. सो फर्स्ट वन इज अ 21 माइनस 16, दैट गिव्स मी 5, एंड 8 5 इज अ 40, ओके. सो दिस माइनस एंड माइनस बिकम प्लस 8, सो माइनस 18 प्लस 8 बिकम्स माइनस 18 प्लस 8 बिकम्स माइनस 10, एंड माइनस 10 एंड दिस 6 बिकम्स माइनस 60. देन 24 माइनस 14, 24 माइनस 14 इज 10, 10 टू जा 20, सो वी हैव प्लस 20 देयर. सो 40 प्लस 20 दैट बिकम्स प्लस 60, एंड दिस माइनस 60 गिव्स मी द 0, सो हेंस डिटर्मिनेंट ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू 0. नाउ सिंप्लीफाई दिस फर्स्ट, लैम्बडा क्यूब माइनस 8 प्लस 7 प्लस 3, विच इज नथिंग बट 18 लैम्बडा स्क्वायर, ओके, प्लस 8 इंटू 7 प्लस 7 इंटू 3 प्लस 3 इंटू 8, सो 8 इंटू 7 प्लस 7 इंटू 3 प्लस 3 इंटू 8, दैट गिव्स मी 101. नेक्स्ट माइनस, माइनस 6 इंटू माइनस 6 गिव्स मी, यस इट इज 36, सो दिस इज माइनस 36, ओके. नेक्स्ट माइनस 2 इंटू 2, दैट गिव्स माइनस 4. नेक्स्ट माइनस 4 इंटू माइनस 4 गिव्स मी प्लस 16, बट देर इज अ माइनस साइन, सो माइनस 16, सो दैट गिव्स मी द टोटल वैल्यू ऑफ दिस ब्रैकेट इज 45 इंटू लैमडा माइनस डिटर्मिनेंट ऑफ ए, दैट इज 0. सो हिन्स माई कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इक्वेशन इज लैम्बडा क्यूब माइनस 18 लैम्बडा स्क्वायर प्लस 45 लैम्बडा इज इक्वल टू 0. नाउ गेटिंग द रूट्स ऑफ दिस इज क्वाइट ईजी. सी देर इज नो कॉन्स्टेंट टर्म, सो वी कैन टेक लैम्बडा कॉमन फ्रॉम ऑल द टर्म्स, सो टेक इट कॉमन, सो लैम्बडा इंटू ब्रैकेट द फर्स्ट टर्म बिकम्स लैम्बडा स्क्वायर, द सेकेंड टर्म बिकम्स माइनस 18 लैम्बडा प्लस 45 इज इक्वल टू 0. नाउ वी नीड टू फैक्टराइज दिस क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल, ओके. सो दैट फैक्टराइजेशन इज क्वाइट ईजी, 15 3 जा 45 एंड 15 प्लस 3 18, सो वॉट वी डू इज हियर वी रिक्वायर्ड अ माइनस साइन, सो माइनस 15 माइनस 3 इज अ फैक्टराइजेशन ऑफ द माइनस 18, सो लैमडा स्क्वायर माइनस 15 लैमडा माइनस 3 लैमडा प्लस 45, एंड द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ माइनस 15 एंड माइनस 3 इज प्लस 45, सो देर इज नो नीड टू वरी, दिस इज equal to lambda into bracket, okay. See, we can have lambda common from here, so we get lambda minus 15 as a one bracket. From here we can have minus 3 common, so inside of the bracket we get lambda minus 15. So one of the factor of this is lambda minus 15, and the another factor is lambda minus 3. So either lambda is equal to 0, or lambda minus 15 is equal to 0, or lambda minus 3 equal to 0. Hence the possible values are, if lambda is equal to 0, then lambda equal to 0 is one of the eigenvalue, lambda minus 3 is equal to 0, the second eigenvalue is 3, and the third eigenvalue is 15. See, your matrix is of order 3 by 3, so you will get 3 eigenvalues, either all of them are distinct or some of them are going to repeat, but there must be 3 values for the lambda if your matrix is of order 3 by 3, okay. So now you can say all the eigenvalues are distinct here, so we can apply the Cramer's rule while calculating the eigenvectors, okay. So to find the eigenvector, consider a matrix equation, a matrix A minus lambda I into capital X is equal to 0. Now already we computed the A minus lambda I here, the same A minus lambda I will be taken for the eigenvector calculation. Hence we get 8 minus lambda minus 6, 2, then minus 6, 7 minus lambda minus 4, 2 minus 4, 3 minus lambda, okay, into x, y, z, that is my matrix of unknowns, 0, 0, 0, okay. Now, the first eigenvalue which I am going to take is for lambda is equal to 0. So, when I substitute lambda is equal to 0 in this, we get 8 minus 0, 7 minus 0, 3 minus 0. So, your coefficient matrix will remain same, that is 8 minus 6, 2, minus 6, 7, minus 4, 2 minus 4, 3, into x, y, z, 0, 0, 0, okay. Now, by Cramer's rule, we are going to calculate the eigenvector, okay. So, by Cramer's rule. Now, how to apply the Cramer's rule? It's very simple. See, there are three unknowns. So, write down them first, x, y, and z. The first having the plus sign, the second will have minus sign, and the third will have the plus sign. Put a equality in between them. Now, we have to write their denominators. So, denominators are nothing but the minors we are going to select. Minors means, it's very simple. The while calculating the determinant of a matrix, we used to calculate the minors. So, this is one minor, minor of 8. So, minor of 8 is nothing but we deleted this first column and the first row. So, we get this small part of the matrix. And the determinant of this part is nothing but your minor of 8. Similarly, the minor of 6 is we delete the first row and the second column. So, we get these four entries, minus 6, minus 4, 2 and 3, whose values can computed here. So, this is minor. Okay. Now, how to select these minors at the place of denominators? It's very simple. You have to select any two rows from this matrix. Now, while selecting the rows, try to select a row which are independent of each other. That means a row cannot be written in the form of another row. So, the rows which you are going to select, they cannot be written in the form of each other. So, think of it carefully. So, I am just going to select the first and the second row. Okay. Now, as this is a minor in the denominator of x, so we delete the first column. X is associated with the first column, so we delete the x. So the remaining part is minus 6, 2, 7, minus 4. Now for y, delete the middle column. See, I am selecting the first two rows. Now delete the first second column. Write down the entries 8, minus 6, 2, minus 4. Next, for z, delete the third column, we have 8, minus 6, minus 6, 7. Okay, so this implies. Solve these determinants. Minus 6 into minus 4, that gives the plus 24, minus 14 is equal to minus y divided by 8, 4 is 32, but there is minus 32, minus 6 into 2, that is minus 12, z divided by 87, that is 56, minus minus 6 into minus 6 becomes plus 36. Okay, so this implies x is equal to 24 minus 14. Yes, 24 minus 14 is 10, correct? Then for y, it is minus minus become plus, so plus 12, and this is minus 32. So minus 32 plus 12 gives me minus 20. Okay. For z, 56 minus 36. Can you tell me what is the answer? 56 minus 36. Yes, correct. It is plus 20. Hence, my eigenvector is, for x, the value is 10. For y, just be careful about this. In the numerator also we have a minus sign, in the denominator we have a minus sign. So minus minus become plus, hence I write here 20. But if your denominator value is a positive, then in that case the negative sign will be given to the denominator and the value will be written here with a negative sign. So just be careful about this. as both the numerator and denominator having the minus, hence it becomes plus. If one of them is minus, then it becomes a minus 20. Okay. In general, we can simplify this as if I divide it by 10, we get 1, 2, 2. So 1, 2, 2 is my eigenvector corresponding to lambda is equal to 0. Are you clear with that? Yeah, of course. Now here you can select first and the third row also, or you can select second and the third row also. The choice is yours. But the answers which you will obtain will be in the multiplication of 1, 2, 2. Like as this. I have selected the first and second row, so I am getting 10, 10, 20, 20. If you select second and third row, you will get some different values, but they are in the multiples of this vector. Are you clear with this? Yeah. So when eigenvalues are distinct, then we get only one eigenvector corresponding to it. That is a unique eigenvector. Yeah, of course. Person to person, the calculations will vary. But ultimately, your final answer will give you this value which is in multiples of each other. For example, you one student is A and other student is B and they are solving the same problem, but their calculations are different. It's fine, but whatever the answers they obtain must be in multiples of each other. Okay, so just remember this very important point regarding the eigenvector corresponding to this. Now we will do for one more eigenvalue. That is lambda is equal to 15, and lambda is equal to 3, I will leave it for homework. Now for lambda is equal to 15, my matrix is 8 minus lambda. 8 minus lambda, that is 8 minus 15. So what is the value of 8 minus 15? It is minus 7. Next, 7 minus lambda, but lambda value is 15 here, so 7 minus 15 is minus 8, and third, 3 minus 15, so 3 minus 15 is minus 12, is it? And the non-diagonal entries are same, minus 6, then 2, then minus 4 here, minus 6, 2, minus 4, into x, y and z. Okay, now, as I already told, the choice is yours. Here I will select the second and the third row. So x, y and z, the y is with a minus sign. Put an equality in between them. As I am going to select this second and the third line, for x, again same, delete the first column, whatever the remain, you select it, minus 8 into minus 12. Plus 96 minus minus 4 into minus 4 becomes plus 16. So minus 16 we get there. Similarly, for y, delete the middle column and take these four entries. So minus 6 into 12, that is 72, minus minus 4 into 2, that gives me the minus 8. Next is z. For the z, we delete the third column, so we have this one. So 6 4 is 24. Minus 6 into minus 4 becomes minus 6 into minus 4 becomes plus 24. Okay, minus 8 to the 16, but 8 is having a negative sign, so we get a minus 16 there. So x divided by 96 minus 16. What is the answer? 96 minus 16, that gives me the 80. Minus y divided by 72 minus minus become plus 8, that gives me again 80. And here minus minus become plus, so z divided by 24 plus 16, that is 40. Okay, so hence my eigenvector is 80. Now see the middle value. The denominator is plus, numerator is minus. So one of them is minus. Hence, here I will write a value with a negative sign. Next, 40. Like as the previous, You can take a common part of it out of it, or you can divide it by 40. So hence I get 2 minus 2, 1 is the my eigenvector. Ah, yes, if someone selects the first and the second row, you will get a different answer. Are you clear with this? It's very important. Okay, I'll just demonstrate the same part here. Here I selected the first and the second and the third row. Here I will go on selecting the first and second row. Second and third row selection. So this is my answer. To verify whatever I told you in the selection, I am explaining here. Here I will select first and second row. Our claim is we get the eigenvector which is in multiples of this. Okay. So x divided by first and second row I am selecting. So delete the first column. 6, 4 is that is 24. 24 minus 8 to the 16. But there is minus sign. Next, minus y divided by, delete the middle column, 7 4 is, that is 28, minus, minus 6 into 2, that gives minus 12. And z divided by, delete the third column, 7 8 is, that is 56, minus, minus 6 into minus 6, that gives me the plus 36, but there is minus in here. Okay. So x divided by 24 minus minus plus 16. So that gives me the 40. Minus y divided by 28 plus 12. That gives me the 40 again. And z divided by 56 minus 36, which is nothing but 20. So now here I am getting x as 40. Now see the denominator having the plus sign. And numerator having the negative sign, so minus sign is with a value, so minus 40 here, then 20. Now if we divide it by 20 throughout, so 40 divided by 20 is 2, here we get a minus 2 and here I am getting 1. Now you can see. And see these values. This is in multiples of this vector. Is it? So the selection can be any bin, any rows you can select. But your answer must be in multiples of each other. Means whatever the answer I am getting, whatever the answer you will get, it should be in multiples of each other. Now, I am leaving one problem. That means I am leaving the part of lambda is equal to 3 as a homework for you. Now, second thing, when you will come for the next lecture, you just try to get eigenvalues of the one matrix. Okay, so that matrix I am just going to give you here. The matrix A is 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 3, 4. Now everyone should solve this problem for eigenvalues only. I will explain the part of eigenvectors in the next video. Okay. So you solve this problem and post your answer on my WhatsApp or the email. Thank you, everyone.